Hey Virgo, welcome to your monthly reading for March 2023. My name is Johanna. Welcome to Tenacious Soul. We're going to go through some general messages here for you guys. So take what resonates, leave the rest. You're going to check out your sun, your moon, your rising sign. Let's see, Virgo. All right, we got a bunch here that just flipped. Okay, so we have magic, we have anger, we have fear, success, and faith. Okay. I was trying to just pull three cards, but you guys got lots coming out here. Okay. Virgo. Bottom of the deck, we have growth. I feel as though you might have a little bit of, there could be definitely some fears. I'm almost getting like with this anger, like a frustration around, like you have like an emotion, a negative emotion coming up here that I think could be indicating like a block or, kind of like a block, or it's like there's a fear that's rooted in a bit of like a frustration almost. You could be frustrated with like your process when it comes to working through a fear as well, right? You do have a lot though, like with this magic energy, like you have all the magic you need. This is like High Priestess energy for me. You have everything that you need. I think you're realizing that, but you're like, why am I stuck? Why am I, like, it's kind of like frustration around that. What's holding me back from having this success and really believing that I can make something happen? It's like you believe it, but then maybe you're struggling to see the results of like the progress of something. So then that makes you kind of doubt. I feel like this is kind of highlighting like keeping a, when you start to feel this like anger, this fear, one, address and kind of figure out like, okay, why is this coming up for me right now? And then once you do that, it's about course correcting yourself, right? Kind of shifting that energy to not let that like stagnate in your energy here. Because I do feel like you're trying to grow, you're trying to evolve here, you're trying to have success, bring your magic into the world, right? Maybe trying to manifest something specifically, but there's the frustration with the process of it at this point. What else is going on for Virgo here? Yeah, look at that. We have success again. So two success cards. It says, believe in yourself and dare to dream big. And we have, yeah, shadow work. There are no shadows without light. So I feel like that's just highlighting this like fear. Okay, this like shadow energy that's right in the center. Shining the light on what's stopping you from having faith, having belief in yourself, in the situation, that you can make something happen here for you, for yourself, right? Like, what is it that's kind of coming up for you right now? And then we have trust. Approach the situation with a light heart. So yeah, there is definitely something here around like freeing up your energy around this success in your life that you're trying to have, or this positive outcome that you're trying to have. There's a little bit of like resistance because of this emotion that's coming up here. Let's see, let's get another card for you here, Virgo, for March. We have Page of Swords. So truthful, perceptive, analytical, blunt. It says an exciting new challenge. You have what it takes to succeed. Again, another success, succeed energy. We have review contracts or documents very thoroughly. The bottom of the deck, we have the Fool with leap of faith. Believe in yourself. And then we have that, believe in yourself. Listen to your heart and do what gives you joy. So you can succeed if you believe, which sounds so corny, but it's honestly the truth. Like if you believe in something, like nobody is going to be able to sway you from that. You could be gaining a sense of like insight or truth, or wanting to kind of figure something out. Like you could be just really looking at this right now, really trying to be perceptive of like, hey, what's going on? Taking on this challenge of like, you know what? I'm going to overcome this fear. I'm going to overcome this block. There's like a sense of determination here. We have the Lovers. This could be a choice here that's coming up here for you. What else is going on for Virgo? Five of Pentacles. What does Virgo need to know? Nine of Wands and the Queen of Pentacles. Okay, so, and we do have this Knight of Coins. So things might kind of be moving slow here this month, or just like, I feel like this is your energy really, the Knight of Pentacles here. This is like slow moving progress, but dedication, like really being dedicated and sticking to the plan and being consistent with something. I feel as though there's a sense of you maybe needing to choose here with the Lovers, actually all of these, with the Lovers, the Five of Pentacles, the Nine of Wands, the Queen of Pentacles. You have to choose whether you're going to stay in this sense of doubt, this pattern possibly, right? Are you going to keep repeating this cycle, or are you going to choose to step out and grow from the situation? I feel like that's kind of what you're being asked here with this shadow work. It's like, are you willing to do the work needed? Are you willing to dive deep into this situation here for yourself, this possibly this doubt or this sense of lack or some sense of like feeling like you don't have what it is that you're looking for? Are you going to let that consume you, or are you going to rise above the challenge and keep moving forward? Nine of Wands is also a card of persistence. So it's like, are you going to keep moving forward and keep putting in the dedication to having this succeed and having faith that this will succeed and move forward, and I will succeed and move forward if it's like a personal thing. Why is this Five of Pentacles here for Virgo? Why is this Five of Pentacles here for Virgo? Four of Cups. Yeah, there's like kind of this sense of doubt, like, and kind of this glum type of feeling. We have the Two of Cups. We have Temperance. I almost feel like it's like feeling like things aren't coming together, right? Things aren't in the Temperance, and traditionally there's two cups and the person is the angel, usually is kind of like pouring from like one cup into the other, right? And it's interesting that we have the Two of Cups come out here. So there's like this sense of things not coming together, feeling like things aren't coming together. Maybe you feel like you haven't found your person. Maybe you feel like what you've been putting your time and your energy into from a work perspective or a creative perspective isn't coming together. And I feel like that's not the truth. It's just that it's taking some time here, which is you know, kind of like just throwing you off a little bit here. And that's when I think it's like when things start to take time, you start to doubt, you start to have fear, you start to worry, what if this isn't the direction I'm supposed to be going into? But with the Lovers, it's asking you like, have faith in what it is that you feel called to step into or to do here, right? The Lovers for me is sometimes a card of like an alignment. Yeah, Temperance again. So trusting where you're led. Both the Lovers and the Temperance have an angel on them traditionally. And so it's like, trust what feels in alignment with you. Trust what feels like you want to actually put energy and time into and create here. We do have this Five of Wands at the bottom, which makes me feel like there's a sense of you needing to maintain a sense of peace or calm within yourself when, if this is taking time and it's throwing you off and making you feel frustrated, anger, whatever, fears, whatever emotions kind of coming up here for you. It's like taking a step back and recentering yourself to get yourself back into alignment here. Why is the Nine of Wands here for Virgo? Clarify this Nine of Wands. We do also have this full moon. Like, as I'm recording this, the full moon is just about to happen in March in your sign. So this could also be what's influencing you right now. Yeah, Nine of Wands, we have the Four of Wands and the Knight of Cups. This is like persevering and pushing forward, moving towards the path that you want to see. The Four of Wands is a card of success, achievement. And I just feel like it's follow your heart, follow where you feel led, and don't give up on that. Have the strength to persevere and to stick to something here. Why the Queen of Coins? And I don't really feel like you're going to give up. It's just that there's this energy that you're needing to kind of push through. Queen of Pentacles is clarified by the Queen of Wands. So this is having a level of confidence. Also really looking after yourself and your own needs. And, you know, keeping, again, two queens. So the keeping your energy and your vibration high, whether you're male or female, doesn't matter. But it's like keeping your vibration high, keeping that, especially if you're trying to create something or there's a level of creativity or even two, if you're not seeing Two of Swords, Nine of Cups, if you're not seeing the wish fulfillment yet, you have to maintain that high vibration energy, even though you're maybe not seeing the results you want at this moment. What is the advice here for Virgo? What is the advice here for Virgo for March 2023? What is the advice? We have the Queen of Cups, we have the Ten of Swords, the Two of Swords, and the Nine of Cups. Bottom of the deck, we have the Star. So I feel like this is asking you to keep moving forward, especially with the Star at the bottom of the deck. There's some healing here around, I think, just you continuing to push and move forward. I feel like with this Ten of Swords, it's about putting those mental fears, those mental, it's the Swords energy, so the Swords are like the mind. I feel like there's a sense of you detaching from some form of thought process here, or your advice is to work through that. Have compassion for yourself, access. It's like getting out of the mind and more into the heart. With the Queen of Cups, the Nine of Cups, and then we got the Two Swords energies here. Two of Swords can be using your logic and your intuition, is kind of how I view it, like blocking out the mind or blocking out other people in order for you to make the decision that's right for you, right? And I feel as though it's like basically not letting this Ten of Swords energy like get the best of you. Don't let this pull you down. Don't let this anger, this fear, this frustration like slow you down from stepping into this really positive experience that you know that you can have. It's like having faith of things. It's like you're hitting some sort of bumps in the road here. Now, this could also be, especially if you're watching this when I'm posting it, it's like this could definitely be releasing some of these energies around the full moon. There might be some fears and some doubts and some anger and some frustration that is coming up for you, that showing you to release this energy. So this might be something, if you do full moon and work, you can set that intention around letting this go, in order to clear the way for your success, so that you can continue to see growth and expansion and progress. And this is a little bit of like trusting the process and releasing the restriction and the resistance you have that's currently showing up for you on your current path, so that you can continue to move forward towards that path that you're trying to manifest and create here for yourself. You can have the success. The success is here multiple times in these cards. You just have to believe that you can have it and not get in your own way. So that is what I have for you, Virgo. Hopefully that resonates. Let me know down below. If not, you can check out any of your other signs. But I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for watching, liking, subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.